Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Street Fix by Naf. I hope you all are doing good, inshallah. So today I will be doing another voiceover for my mom's video because this week was very busy for her. So I decided to help her a little bit. And today we're going to be making waffles and pancakes from the same batter. So if you don't have any waffle makers, that's absolutely 100% fine because you can always make pancakes with a pan, and obviously everyone has a pan in their house. So they're so very easy to make, and in 10 to 12 minutes you can have an amazing breakfast or maybe a snack ready for your house. And then you can always top it up with some caramel, maple syrup, chocolate, sprinkles, fruits, anything you like. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So the twist of this recipe is that we're going to be making it in a blender or a grinder, and I'd kindly request you guys to please watch the whole video for all the techs and techniques. And now kindly note down the ingredients. First, we will be sieving 2 cups of flour and 2 teaspoons of baking powder together. Then we are going to be kneading 1/2 cup of sugar. It should be white sugar. Then we need 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence. You can use it according to your taste. And then we need 1 cup of milk, or according to your need. And then we are going to be kneading 2 eggs. And know that all the ingredients should be on room temperature to make the perfect pancakes and waffles. As I already told you guys in the start, that we are going to be making this recipe in a blender or a grinder. So first of all, you're going to be blending the eggs and the sugar together until they're soft and fluffy. Here, I would like to give a huge shout out and a huge thank you to Dani Mamu and Amna Mami for bringing this amazing Bosch Silent Mix Blender. Guys, it's so amazing, and just like the name, it's silent, like literally. So if you're hungry at night or maybe want to make pancakes sometime and not disturb your parents, you can always make it in this, and it will literally make sounds so less that maybe it couldn't go in the other room. Getting back to the recipe, after the eggs and the sugar are completely blended, we have to add in oil and the vanilla essence, and then you have to blend again. After it is fully blended, add in 1 cup of room temperature milk and then blend again. After your batter is ready, it will be really runny, just like milk, so you don't have to worry at that time at all, because we have to add our flour and the pre-mixed baking powder, and then when we stir it and mix it again, it will be just like a perfect batter consistency. You can see it's very perfectly batter-like, and you do not have to use any electrical beaters at this point, just use a whisk to take out all the lumps that there are. So then you have to pour this mixture into a batter dispenser. If you don't have a batter dispenser, that's absolutely 100% fine. You can use a piping bag or maybe a sauce bottle or a water bottle or simply a spoon. There are so many alternatives. But I think that batter dispensers are way better because they're so much more neater than other stuff like spoons or bottles. So I would suggest you guys to use piping bags or a batter dispenser. So if you're using a waffle maker, I would suggest you guys to always grease your pans with oil, because here we forgot to do that, but it did come out pretty well, but it could have been better. After pouring your batter, you should always even it out with a spatula, and then you have to set your waffle timings or maybe your waffle settings. So we have the West Point one, and it has 2 options, light and dark, so we're setting it a bit more than light. So I remind you that you should always grease your pans. Always grease your pans to get the best results. And ta-da! We have our waffles ready, and they were so easy to make. So as you can see, they were a bit hard to get off the waffle maker, but you know, always grease your pants. That was a lesson for us. And we're showing you both sides. So this is the front side, and in a second you can see the flipped back side of it. And yeah, this is the flipped back side, and I like this way more because it has a way more bronzer color, and I just love it so much. So we're doing the same with the second waffle, and yeah, that's it. Alright, now we're done with the waffles, we are going to be making some pancakes, and for that you have to preheat your pan, and then you are going to be adding in a squirt or a dollop of, you know, the pancake mix or a waffle mix, and then you have to let it sit for like, I guess, a minute, and then it will be heated, and then you can flip it over. When it starts to bubble up, you will know when you can flip it. And when we flipped it, you can see it's really nice and pretty, and it's right light and brown, and it's cute. As you might have noticed, that they were so super easy and so super quick to make, and then when they're done, you can go ahead and decorate just as you like. You can always use maple syrup or caramel or whatever is available. So in my house, only chocolate and the sprinkles were available, so we did that. And they were so super fluffy and so super soft, and they were so tasty and, you know, yummy and lovely and so appealing because the decoration was so amazing too, and they were my favorite snack for like the whole week, and I just loved them so much. That was it for today's video. Be sure to like, subscribe, share and comment, and also follow Sweet Fix by NF on Facebook and Instagram. Until then, take the best care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.